Each airport in the National Airspace System has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Salt Lake City International is a large commercial airport located northwest of the city of Salt Lake City, Utah. While it consists mostly of air carrier traffic, there is a robust business and general aviation presence located on the east side of the airport. The runway configuration consists of a set of parallel runways, 16 left and right, and 34 left and right, on either side of the airline terminal, and are primarily used for air carrier operations. East of runway 16 left, 34 right, there are two more runways, 1432 and 1735, that are commonly used for the business and general aviation community. Runway 1735 is also regularly used by air carriers. All of the general aviation facilities and businesses can be found east of runway 1735. A complex taxiway system connects all parts of the airport. While runways 1432 and 1735 do not intersect, the approach ends of runway 32 and 35 are in close proximity to each other. Hotspot 1 can be found there. Aircraft cleared for takeoff on one runway have attempted to depart the other. One possible factor in this error may be that the same hold short line is used for both runways on taxiways Kilo 1 and taxiway Mike. Additionally, the wide expanse of pavement can cause confusion. Verifying your aircraft heading before takeoff with your takeoff runway clearance should help avoid this error. While this location is listed as a wrong runway departure risk, it also presents a hazard to approaching aircraft. Pilots cleared to land on one runway have landed or attempted to land on the other, or on taxiway Kilo. Close attention to landing runway clearance and positive identification of the runway itself are essential factors in avoiding this error. At the other end of the runway, especially at night, pilots arriving from the west and cleared to land on runway 17 have mistakenly lined up on runway 16 left. One technique for ensuring an approach to the correct runway would be to load an instrument approach to that runway or use the GPS user waypoint or panning function to identify the final approach course to the desired runway. Inbound aircraft to runway 35 at KSLC face a unique challenge when landing. The common instrument approach to runway 35 is the LDA approach. While common at Salt Lake City, this type of approach is not so common across the rest of the country. Depending on the type of approach, with or without the glide slope, this approach provides guidance to approximately 0.5 nautical miles with the glide slope, or to 1.1 nautical miles with the visual descent point if using the localizer only. More uncommon is the turn, as the localizer is offset by 4 degrees in order to align with the runway. This increases the potential for a misalignment on the parallel taxiway Kilo. Hotspot 2 is located at the approach end of runway 14 and taxiway Quebec. Pilots taxiing east on taxiway Quebec have mistakenly crossed the hold short line for the runway. Some of these pilots were instructed to hold short of the runway, while others were supposed to turn south on taxiway Lima and missed the turn. Pilots are reminded that an ATC clearance is required to cross any runway, active or not. Though not a hot spot, pilots should use care when exiting runway 1735 at taxiways Kilo 5 and 6. Both taxiways join the runway at a single, wide opening, and pilots have sometimes started to turn on the first taxiway they come to before changing their mind and turning back along the runway to the other taxiway. This delays them clearing the runway and conflicts with subsequent arrivals or departures. A similar situation exists on runway 16 left, 34 right, at taxiways Hotel 4, 5, and 6, and Hotel 7 and 8. Hotspot 3 also denotes a runway incursion hazard. Aircraft exiting ramps 1 and 2 on taxiway Alpha 4 or Alpha 5 must ensure that they turn onto taxiway Alpha or Bravo and not enter the runway 16 right, 34 left runway safety area. Scanning for signs and markings, as well as reviewing the airport diagram, will help pilots mitigate these risks. One last item for the first-time visitor to Salt Lake. When utilizing runway 1432 for landing or departure, Tower may instruct you to remain east of runway 16 left, 34 right. Compliance with this instruction is critical to avoid conflicting with aircraft using runway 16 left, 34 right. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration challenges at SLC will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Salt Lake City International Airport. It's always better to know before you go.